For the cube root of 40, we have 2 times this cube root of 5. For the 4th root of 48, we have 2 times the 4th root of 3. And for the 4th root of 64, we have 2 times the 4th root of 4. And finally, for our last answer, we'll have 5 times the cube root of 20. Fantastic work for getting at least 3 of those correct. These were pretty tough. For the first one, we can rewrite 40 as 8 times 5. 8 is the same thing as 2 cubed, so now we have a perfect cube, or a factor that appears 3 times within our radical. We can use the product rule to split this radical up into the product of 2 radicals. We know that a cubed root undoes a cubed power, so we're really left with just 2 here. This also goes in line with our thinking of power divided by root. 3 divided by 3 equals 1, so we just have 2 to the 1. We can't simplify the 5, so that stays inside of its cubed root, and we have that multiplied on the end with our answer, 2 times the cube root of 5. For the 4th root of 48, we split up 48 into 16 times 3. We rewrite 16 as 2 to the 4th, and then we can take the 4th root of 2 to the 4th. The root undoes the 4th power. We leave the 3 inside of the 4th root since we don't have 4 factors of 3, we just have 1 of them. So our final answer is 2 times the 4th root of 3. We use a similar method for finding the 4th root of 64. We rewrite 64 as 16 times 4, take the 4th root of 2 to the 4th, which leaves us with 2 times the 4th root of 4. For our last one, we split up 2,500 into 25 times 100. 25 equals 5 squared, and 100 equals 5 times 20. We do this step so that way we can get 3 factors of 5 together. We know that the cube root of 5 cubed is just 5. 20 is not a perfect cube, since the factors of 20 are 2, 2, and 5. There's not 3 factors that repeat. This means 20 stays inside of our cube root, and we're left with our final answer, 5 times the cube root of 20.